the invention of the electric violin was all about turning up the volume. In the big band era, the sound of the traditional violin was overpowered by the horns and drums. Amplifying the violin changed everything. Suddenly, the violin wasn't just background sound, it was part of the show. The electric violin comes in different shapes because it doesn't rely on the body to resonate sound. This craftsman builds the violins one piece at a time, starting with the neck. He traces the shape onto a piece of maple. Then he outlines the top plate. Walnut is used for the bottom part, or lower bout, as well as for the backbone of the violin. Next, a bandsaw is used to cut out the shapes. The more precisely the cuts are made, the less sanding will have to be done later. The dimensions for the top and neck are exactly the same as for a traditional violin, so there won't be any difference in the reference points the violinist relies on. The lower bout has a unique design. And the head is more streamlined than a traditional violin. There's no decorative scroll. Next, a cavity is chiseled out of the head of the violin to create the peg box. Parallel grooves are carved into the back to give it a snazzy look. A rasp is used to shave the wood to the correct thickness. Holes for the turning pegs are drilled into the side of the peg box, one for each of the four strings. After the grooves on the back have been filed a little more, the rest of the neck is scraped to give it a final finish. The peg holes are tapered using a tool called a reamer. The ebony pegs have matching tapers, so they fit snugly into the holes. Everything is checked to make sure it measures up. Wood glue is brushed onto the neck section, and the ebony fingerboard is pressed onto it. Surgical tubing holds them together while the glue dries. Two assembly holes are drilled in the top piece, and corresponding holes are made in the other parts. A sander smooths the edges of the backbone. Then, a high-speed router is used to bevel the lower bout piece to give it a clean edge. The wood is stained. The loud colours seem appropriate for these high-volume instruments. A crystal has been glued into the violin's wooden bridge to generate electricity from the string's vibrations and create sound. The wire from the bridge is pulled through the backbone, and then the bout is mounted to the backbone. An ebony chin rest is bolted on top. Next, the neck is attached to the rest of the assembly. The ebony tailpiece is looped on. A string is pulled from the tailpiece to a peg. The act of tightening the first string raises the bridge, which will be held in place simply by tension. Now it's time to hook up the violin to the amplifier and let the music tell the rest of the story.